गुड इवनिंग, कैन यू ऑल हियर मी?
गुड इवनिंग.
यस सर,
यस यस, वी आर एबल टू हियर.
या गुड इवनिंग.
गुड इवनिंग. सो आई एम मोहन, आई विल बी ट्रेनिंग यू. यू ऑल वांट टू बिकम सीसीएनएस?
यस.
ओके, सो व्हाट इज सीसीएनए?
Cisco Certified Network Associate.
Okay, did I ask you to expand CCNA, Monica? Okay, so let's try to first understand about each other. Anyway, what you all do? What is your background? What's the knowledge? What do you expect out of this course? Yeah, let's start with Monica. She seems to be active. Yeah, Monica.
Yeah, okay. My name is Monica Singh, and I am BTech in computer science. I'm from 2015 batch. I'm working as a network associate here in Black Box. I just want to become a Cisco Certified Network Associate because it is the requirement of my organization, so I can get that promotion. So that will only happen if I'll get certified. So that's why I joined this.
Good.
Yeah. Thanks. Sure. That's all.
Yeah. So who else? Who is next? Who is next?
Hello. Sorry.
Yeah. Just-
Hello. Yeah, I'm Ajit Sunil, and I'm currently in my fourth year of engineering at RV College of Engineering. I'm studying electronics and telecommunication. And my expectation, what I really want to get from this course is I have this interest in networking.
Yeah.
Because we have subjects like CCNA in our college itself.
Yeah, and, I know. Training facility there, right? Cisco Pro has.
Yeah. Cisco is. Has their own training facility. So my base was, the reason I joined was because I wanted to get certified, as right now is my placement season. So okay. It'll expand my reach. You know, it'll really add to my resume.
These days, engineering kids are proactive. Nowadays, we don't know what to do else.
Thank you, sir.
Right, after finishing the college also, we don't have a clue. If parents say something, we'll do that. That's it.
No, I promise this was my, I came forward for this.
Yeah, I know. It's really appreciate that proactiveness. Yes.
Thank you.
So who else?
Yes, this is Shashi Bhushan.
Yeah, Shashi.
I completed my master degree in 2014 batch. Okay. Presently, I'm working in Concentrix India Private Limited for Lenovo process hardware, all laptop, desktop, and all-in-one hardware support.
Okay.
And I'm looking my career in networking, so I joined this one.
You heard of Ganesh Chandrasekaran?
Sir?
You heard of Ganesh Chandrasekaran in Concentrix? Used to be in CEO.
Ganesh Chandrasekaran is, they are not visiting in our Lenovo client because they may be in Maneta Tech Park.
No. He used to be an India head. He is now, I think, global lead. He's there in Denver. Yeah.
No, sir, I do not know.
I mean, one of the top five guys in your.
Umesh, I know, he's a head for our India, I think.
Okay. Anyway, I just like that I asked you.
Thank you.
Your leadership, actually.
Yeah. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Thank you, sir.
So, yeah. Who else?
Sir, this is Mulay from Uzur.
Yeah, Mulay. What? You disappeared and reappeared? Yeah, I know. You are the one with the service provider?
Yeah, sir. ISP.
Yeah, ISP. Okay. I remember.
Yeah, I missed that classes last 3-4 weeks.
Okay. Okay. So who else?
Hi, this is Neha Sharma.
Yeah, Neha.
Good evening, sir. I rejoined this this CCNA classes. I joined in the month of January, and because of this lockdown, I didn't complete. So this is my revision classes. Currently, I'm working with MTech. So this time, I am thinking to prepare well and go for the CCNA certified level, so okay. that I can clear my exam this time. So,
okay. Okay.
Yeah. Yeah. Thank you, sir.
Yeah. Who else?
Hi, I'm Surabhi.
Yeah, Surabhi.
I completed engineering in 2014, and I work as a service desk support specialist. So I'm looking forward to switch my domain.
Okay. Where do you work?
ACI Worldwide.
Okay. Okay. It's a technical product or?
It is actually. Okay. It's actually a banking company, but then we handle all the hardware, software, and everything related to them.
Okay. Okay. Good. Who else?
Hello, sir. Myself, Madhu Anand.
Yeah, Madhu.
Good evening, sir.
Good evening.
Sir, actually, I completed my BA in this year, 2020.
Okay.
So I want to get my job. Okay. So I was little interested in networking. So okay. that's why I'm getting into CCNA, sir.
Okay. Who else?
Thank you.
Who is pending?
Okay. Yes,
Lakshmipathi, yeah.
Yeah. Hi, Mohan. This is Lakshmipathi Naidu. I'm from IBM.
Okay.
I have around 20 plus years work experience, most of time in IBM.
Okay.
Okay. So I attended your classes sometime 2004. okay. This is the second time attending to complete my certificate, actually, as you know, recertificate, in fact,
okay.
For the project purpose.
Okay. Yeah. Good. 2004, I used to do the corporate training for you guys, right? Lot of.
Actually, we individually joined that time. Otherwise, you was doing that time in Koramangala.
Yeah.
Now, where the IBM was only, we around 10, 15 people joined that time, actually.
Okay. Yeah, I think the global services, the whole team I trained, I guess.
Yeah, exactly. Nah, so, this is, now... It's clearly told that no more projects if you are not doing the recertificate. Otherwise, I do have experience. I'm working in the CUCM. All the,
actually, this is in a way good for this all these young kids out here to know that they can't leave their certifications expiring, right? Every 3 years they have to do something, so that if in this industry. That is the measurement for especially multinational companies.
I know. Without certificates, if you want to really grow, certificate is only the way you can grow, actually. Yeah. Otherwise, good, you know, whatever hard work, whatever efforts you put it,
I know.
Certificate only, you know, make you that special.
See, it's simple common sense. All of you have to understand Lakshmipathi's case.
Yeah.
If you see all the young kids, how do the people know that you are knowledgeable? Right, unless
exactly.
your face of it is the certification, right? It's compulsory now. All the multinationals coming in, new opportunities coming up now. IT industry, it's compulsory. You all joined here. I'm not selling my certificate, okay?
Yes. No, I always inform to my friends and family also. You know, whatever your position, don't miss the certification part. Yeah. Otherwise your career will be thank you.
So who else is, thank you. Who else is missing here? Ritu is the only one who did not speak. Are you there, Ritu? And Akshay.
Hi, sir.
Yeah, sir.
Myself, Ritesh. This is the second class I'm taking, sir. Because of marketing, sales and marketing, I couldn't able to make my time.
Okay.
Yeah, I just wanted to start my career in IT sector, from sales and marketing to IT sector.
Okay.
So I have taken this, sir.
All kinds of mix in the class.
Yes, sir.
So who else? Yeah. Akshay spoke.
Yes, myself, Akshay Vijayan.
Yeah.
I completed my graduation in BSc Computer Science.
Okay.
I'm looking for a job. Opportunity, and I likely doing networking. That's why I joined. Yeah.
Okay.
Thank you.
Okay. So who else is pending? Ram?
Hi all. Good morning, sir. Good evening, all. Yeah. I am again from IBM. I am Lakshmi's colleague. my experience to 25 plus years, it's in into ITSM. Basically, I'm a process guy. And I completed the host of certifications like PMI, PMI, ACP, and other nearly 7 to 8 certifications. And last year, I completed my JNCA as well. Now I'm actually a part of the network operations squad. Like we have 3 squads globally. And we handle APJ and China for network operations. Apart from that, like now we are into SD-WAN and the IPv6 implementation and all sorts of things. So as Lakshmi rightly said, like this is one of the prerequisites for us to complete this. It's a prerequisite to be in the squad rather. So that's again. And we have come to the right person. We know that we are with the right person.
Yeah, hopefully, yeah. See, the only thing is, so about me, if I see, I've been singing this song for quite some time. I don't sing it wrong, if not great.
No doubt on that. We know about you very well. Yeah. Not now. No, long back. Yeah. Not now.
Yeah. It's an opportunity to because it's online now, so probably it becomes much easier. Yeah. Like earlier, coming to the center there at Core Mangala, the timings wouldn't match, and like there were a host of other obstacles as well.
Yes.
But now, like actually, we feel that this more comfortable, and the timing also it suits us very well. So thank you for this opportunity. Yeah. Thank you.
Thank you. Yeah, everybody can hear. Akshay, can you hear me now?
Yes, sir. Yes.
Yeah. Okay. So let me know if you can't hear, but generally there won't be any problem as such because it's been a lot of batches I'm taking for the last 4 or 5 months. But anyway, we are dependent on the technology anyway, right? Airtel, ACT, a lot of people for this remote thing. So you will have some hiccups sometimes, you'll log out, you'll come in. So we'll take care of it. So don't worry about that. So we'll take care of those kind of things. So, yes. So, we'll start. Today is the first day. I don't want to trouble you with too much of subject. When I asked what is CCNA, Monica said Cisco Certified Network Associate. Okay, fine. That's an expansion of it. So, what do you think? See, all of you, some of you are freshers, some of you are experienced. Obviously, you all must have done enough of research. Anyway, Lakshmipathy and Ram knows what it is, but otherwise, the rest of the people, you're in the industry, some of you. What exactly you're expecting to learn in this course? Today, I'll only talk about what is that you're going to learn in this course. What is CCNA? So what exactly, especially freshers are there, those who are seeking jobs. My sincere advice out of my experience is in the current market, certification is one thing. And then you have to talk. You have to sell yourself. Classroom is the classic place where you sell yourself, you talk, you exchange. Say if you have a problem, it can be corrected here. You don't need to worry about what others think, because at least online, that is one more advantage. In a physical room, probably you may think somebody is looking at me if I give a wrong answer or if I make a wrong statement. Now nobody knows who you are. So the more you communicate, the more you learn. That is my first and last advice to you people. It's your knowledge. You paid for it. Then you have to take it. I will do my job. That's my job. I've been doing it for quite some time. So I'll do it without anything, because that's my livelihood. So I will not do any mistake in doing it. So you wanted to learn it, then you have to talk. You have to, if you don't understand, you have to ask me, and you have to participate in discussions. You answer questions, then you learn better. Same things will happen in interview. Generally, I ask questions which probably a client will ask you, or in an interview they ask you. So you have to participate, especially those who are looking for jobs and those who are up, want to go to the next level. Obviously, we are all, you and me, everybody is doing for our livelihood, right? You wanted to go to the next level using this knowledge. So yes, and that too, CCNA has changed in this year. They changed it for good. You know, there used to be 10 different CCNAs. Now they made it into one single CCNA. And then the total structure has been changed. Slowly, as and when we reach there, I'll tell you why they changed, what they changed, and all that. So, yeah. Now, my first question to you before I start the class is, what do you think? What is CCNA for you individually? Anybody? What do you expect to learn?
Switches, networking concepts.
Okay. Okay. Anybody else?
I think if we are supposed to grow in the network domain, mm-hmm. and if we are interested in, because if, as we know, as a computer engineer, we have three options, like software engineer, hardware engineer, and network engineer. So if you are more interested in network technology, I think Cisco is the one, which is nowadays every company is using. Like I have been working with Avaya and Nautil. That was like a old products now. So Cisco is something where you want to grow, then you have to start from CCNA just to learn switching, routing, and everything, and make a good career in IT sector.
Okay. Nautil is still there in the market?
Yeah, I'm still working on Nautil.
Nautil is supposed to be the competitor for Cisco 20 years back. There were managers who never liked Cisco. They wanted only Nautil.
Correct.
It just, you know, disappeared from the industry just like that.
Now a few companies are using Mayonnaise also.
Okay. You're not a long time ago.
Yeah.
Okay. So now networking, right? Cisco Certified Network Associate. So you all know what is a network? Can we live without networking? That's interesting, isn't it? What is the first thing you do when you get up from, you know, even from without getting up in the morning, without getting up from the bed, first thing what you do?
Check our phones.
Right? Checking our mobiles.
Right? Your hands will go for, where is my phone? What happened yesterday night? WhatsApp, Instagram, Facebook, right? Emails. So we are all connected so badly now. We cannot dream our lives. We cannot fathom the world without networking. But that's interestingly, people like you and me, okay, we are in technology, we are educated enough, or probably a different strata of the life. The beauty about networking today, as on today, is there is no soul on the earth which is not touched with networking. You take anyone, right? See, today, I generally don't bother, but today, interestingly, my mate's husband sent me a Facebook request. So it's not about the being maid and maid's husband. What I'm telling is that gentleman who is not educated, right, who has no formal education, probably he does some labor kind of a job, but he's using Facebook. And he makes, when he wants to make a call, he makes a WhatsApp call actually. And then he is asking to send the money, salary of the maid, through bank account. So all these three things. He sent me a Facebook request. He makes a WhatsApp call to me, if at all he has to talk to me. And then he is asking, transfer the money to my bank. So very interesting. Somebody who is, why I'm taking it is nothing to do with economic share, but he is in the lowest strata of economical strata in the country, or probably the world. Somebody who earns very less amount of money to his livelihood, but he is using a smartphone and he's connected. And the one, this migration thing, he asked me, you know, because of this migration labor issue, government is giving a lot of money. He said, we will go, we'll take a week's off or 10 days off. We'll go to the village because they're giving us the money. He's from somewhere in the north, some corner of some village, but government is giving them the money. Then he realized government is giving them into their bank accounts. So, you know, that Jan Dhan Yojanas and all, everyone got an account, right? What am I talking about? See, somebody, a small village, some farmer or some daily wage worker through some Rojgar Yojana, government deposited money in his bank account. Let's assume this is a bank. Now, government, because of this COVID situation, I think they initially deposited some 1500 rupees and then later something else, something per head. They kept on giving the money for that. That's what government is claiming, at least. So now, in his bank account, let's say this is a village bank, in his bank account, there is some money government deposited. Now this is a teller machine. Now this gentleman went to the bank to withdraw the money, right? So now assume there is some problem with this machine. He's not able to, the teller is not able to log into the account, or his keyboard is not working, his mouse is not working. Interesting, this is some village, some branch. Now, when this system is not working, he cannot help him. He'll say, bank is not working, I mean, machine is not working, you can come tomorrow. There's no other way. If it is at least Bangalore or something, he would have said, you go to another counter, or there may be somebody, right, who can take care of this. In a village, there is nobody to take care of it. If it's the same thing in the Bangalore branch, somebody may be sitting there who call yourself, yes, hardware engineer or a systems engineer or whatever you call it. He can take care of the problem. So interestingly, Monica said, hardware engineers, network engineers, software engineers, even database, you can say, now that all these differences are narrowing down. Ram used a word, software-defined WAN, SD-WAN, he said. I don't know how many of you noticed. Now, networking people can't escape now. At least some programming is... So there was a difference, yes. As Monica said, when probably she started a career, of course, she's not many years ago, a couple of years ago also, before 2015 to 17. See, networking is different, systems are different, database is different, programming is different. Now, that definition is... No, they wanted multi-talented people. Now, so-called automation, software-defined networking. So you're a Stone Age person if you think that it is different today. Not that you need to know solid programming, but yeah, basic idea. Maybe what is a variable, what is a function, what is an object, how to, you know, how these things work. The small things. I'll introduce you. Don't worry about that. But at the end of the day, now everything is coming back. So that's a different concept. Now, coming back to your bank example, yes, there is a system administrator or a hardware engineer, system engineer, maybe sitting in the same office if it is a Bangalore kind of place and a big branch, or maybe 5-6 branches, one person will be there. So this teller would have called that guy and asked, hey, this system is not working. Problem may be as simple as cable may be loose or something wrong with the operating system or something. But you and me as a technology person, so a lot of you are support people. So we are all support people. Actually, India is a support country. Very few, we don't have a product, isn't it? Do we have any product like Microsoft or Oracle in India? We don't, actually speaking. Whether it is TCS or Infy or, you know, Wipro, or you take any top name in this country, IT, they're all service people. So nothing wrong in support. Our brains, Indian education system, helps that. Support doesn't mean that you sit somewhere and take a call. Maybe sitting here, you manage a network in US. Right, that doesn't, you know, it's that support. Everywhere it supports. So some non-technical person needs a problem, you know, has an issue, then you have to solve it. That's what you and me do. So now in this small situation, if you see, this is where our lives will start. This may be a system, maybe an application, this may be a printer, this may be something. We have to fix this problem. Interestingly, this problem is fixed, right? When this problem is fixed, he can take the money. But when he's taking the money, okay, he's withdrawing 1,000 rupees from his account. But where is that money details? They're not in this branch, in this village. Those details are somewhere here, right? Assume the bank has a head office somewhere in Mumbai. They have a mainframe server here, which has all those details. So when this teller in whatever the village or Bangalore or any branch or this guy, instead of going to the bank, let's assume he went to an ATM to use his debit card and get the money. Or this person is using, I mean, is a little educated person using his mobile phone, using a Paytm or something to transfer the money or withdraw, I mean, put it into somewhere, paying somebody. So in all situations, that information is here in this So this should be connected to this, or this should be connected to this. If it is in Bangalore, if it is in Mumbai, probably 1,000 kilometers away. Or any ATM card anywhere in the world, and any corner, few thousands of kilometers. Or you are in a holiday somewhere and you visited, hopefully you all will go for holidays soon. Things will become right. So you went to a resort or somewhere, or you went to a shop and you wanted to buy something, a t-shirt or a drink or something, then you are using your electronic debit card or a credit card, but the information is here. If you see in this diagram, it's the simplest form of our life. Right? Imagine one more interesting thing. If something goes wrong with this server, what happens to my money? Then I need a backup somewhere else. There will be a backup server, which is having the same information of what my account. Otherwise, only one place they save my account. There's no passbook also these days. How much money is there in your account? How do you know? What is the proof? So where will that backup be? If it is in Mumbai, will this be in Pune or Mumbai? No. Do you know what is the consideration for backup? Seismic zones, earthquake prone zones. In the same Mumbai, if they put in two streets away, if an earthquake comes, both the servers will go. If a fire accident comes, it can be taken care. Any other problem, it can take care, but earthquake might take everything. So if it is in Bangalore, then the copy can be in Delhi, not in anywhere nearby, not even in Hyderabad or Chennai or Mumbai. Right? Maybe some other country. If you go to Bangalore, if you are living, you go to Outer Ring Road, Bangalore, you will see JP Morgan Chase running so many mainframes here. Right? So a different country. So this is the simplest example. Somebody like you and me using on an internet on Amazon, you wanted to buy something. That information has to go to Amazon server and then from to this bank, or and then this should be updated in your branch. Or this farmer went to the bank, he wants to withdraw, it has to go here, here, and here, and here. Right? It has nothing to do with technology, IT companies, nothing. A simple, normal, common man. So this networking, the so-called network in CCNA, that N letter entered into the lives of everybody these days. Right? So that's one reason why you all have to be certified to have a better career. I'm not selling networking here. That's it now. Right? You're already there in the networking class. So if you see here, interestingly, what are the things involved? So within this branch, it is your so-called LAN. Right? Between these branches, 1,000 kilometers, it is what so-called your WAN. I'm not talking about internet. This may be internet. Between these two, it may not be internet. It may be a private dedicated line between two offices. So interesting thing. You want to go from Bangalore to Mumbai, you can go in your own car. You can go in a public transport also. Internet is public. So a bank probably will go in his own car. You are taking 1 crore rupees. You don't go in a government bus. So there will be private connectivities. There will be public connectivities. So generally freshers, if you have a confusion, right? Internet is different. Your own private things are different. So this is in a rough way, this is what networking. You should know how this LAN works, what cable you use, what component you use. What cable you use?
RJ45
is the pin.
Cat 6 cable. Category 5, category 6.
RJ45, you can call it RJ45. Nothing wrong with that. This LAN technology is typically called an Ethernet technology. So Ethernet cable, right? I'll show you the pictures of cable if you are a fresher, you have never seen. You all must have seen the cables, right? Are you understanding? So I'll show you. Now, This is the cable. Now, what is the component in the middle here? What component is in the middle?
Yeah, router.
Switch, maybe.
Switch.
Switch.
Yeah.
Switch.
So this will be a switch. It can be a hub. Hub is old, right? Yeah, Ajit, you should know that. This is switch. Router will not be here. It will be a switch or a hub. Hub is old. Now it is dead almost. Switch. Okay. It will be a switch, right? Huh. Router, when you go out, somewhere here, the router will be there. You should all... Who developed these networks? Human beings, isn't it? People like you and me developed these things. Human being always does things with experience. Out of the blue, things cannot be done. When human being does things with experience, they will put their experience into the, you know. So the same way, the communication, right? Networking is what? Networking is nothing but communication. When you are communicating, the way you and me communicate, systems will communicate. The way you and me travel, data will travel. Because human, the one who developed, his experience only is that. How he's, say for example, somebody, let's assume this X guy lives in this house. When this X guy lives in this house, now he wants to go to meet his friend Y. Now how, what this guy developed networking, let's assume. You know how he developed it? Okay, how do I go and meet Y? So when he wants to develop networking, so Y is here, X is here. X, this is the street where X lives. This is the street where Y lives. Now Y, X wants to go, so he will go here, right? Probably there will be a junction here. Then he will cross. Maybe there is another junction. If this is the path, there may be another junction. This is the path, there may be another junction. This is how he reaches. Maybe there is no road here, let's assume. This is, he goes like this, he goes like this, he'll come like this. So everywhere junction. Why it is junction? Because there may be another road joining here, there may be another road joining here. Or he, X wants to meet A, who lives in the next house, he will just go and meet him. Or, you know, there is B here, X wants to talk to B. X is like, let's say he came out of his house, he's picking up a newspaper here. B is standing here. He wants to talk to him. He'll just shout at him. Hey, B, how are you, man? These days, A is not seen. Hey, let's meet over the weekend, have a drink. Because they're all in the same street. So this is the experience of a human being. Now, that same experience, that this, if that X is a developer of network, let's say, this is my network. This is my lab. X, A, B, and all are in the same street. Oh, Y is in some other LAN. If I want to go to Y, I have to go to a junction and then cross this junction. Imagine it's the first time. So this junction, okay, there are two roads here. Should I go like this or like this? Then there should be a board here which says, hey, this street Y is in this direction. Then here there are three roads. Then there should be a board, hey, street Y is in this direction. That's exactly his network. That's what the X did. Who is the X? The imaginary person who developed your networking. Right? Mohan is teaching you something. Mohan brings his experience into the teaching. Out of the blue, I don't do some yoga and then get some knowledge on it. Whatever I did in my life, whatever I see, if I give you an example, I probably would have studied somewhere. I would have observed something, then put my thought process into it, and then I explain. Right? Say, for example, I'm telling systems will behave like human beings. That I have not read anywhere. Systems are like, so because I felt it over the period of time. So this is what networking is. See, this is an X guy. This is a guy. This is a B guy. They're all in the same system. They want to talk to each other. They'll shout, hi, hello, how are you, man? And they talk. And they want to go out. There is a junction here. That router is the junction. The router is the one which is at the gate and which connects to multiple people. Then this router will go there. There will be another router. Then it will go here. Router is a component which is like a junction which connects you to outside. So one, say this router can connect you to your branch office, that can connect to your internet also. Right? And so there is Amazon here. Amazon has a router. Then there are hundreds of routers here, like junctions. That's how it is. So if you see now, in a network, you will have systems or servers or whatever size they are, you will have these cables and connect them with a switch. And then when you want to go out, then only you need a router. Router is like a junction like this. And every junction, there should be a board. Hey, MG Road, you go like this. Indira Nagar, you go like this. EGL Complex, you go like this. Something like that. And unless and until this board is there, a human being can remember. But machines will follow rules. Only difference between human being and machine for me, or for you also, you have to understand. Only thing is, machines will behave like textbook human beings. That means they follow rules. Good human being, okay, if not this, I'll do that. And the machine is not like, I have to do like this, I'll do like that. Good human beings. Other than that, networking is this. Are you understanding? So now, if I want to connect these 1,000 kilometers, who will connect me? Who will help me to connect that?
Router.
Router is a component, but who is the person who does that job? Right? In between, somebody has to help me, right? So I can't dig the roads and lay down cables, right? If you are the administrator and say, let's assume you are the networking charge of ICICI Bank, do you think you can buy cable and dig the roads and connect 1,000 kilometers?
No.
An ISP?
ISP only.
Telecom service provider. Yeah. Interesting. Internet services are different. Okay. Ajit, I have a question for you. What is the difference between going in your own car and going in a public transport?
I guess you are cost.
Anyone cost. Can answer? What is the difference between your own car and public?
For a private vehicle means security, safety, and public vehicle means there is no
timing,
and you have to be adjust as per their convenience. So it's like that.
Yeah, you're all correct. I'm not saying you're all wrong. Interesting thing. The most important thing is money. You have to buy a car first. Right? That you can't ignore. If you want to have 1,000 kilometers cable from Bangalore to Mumbai, this service provider will charge you handsomely. Whereas in a public transport, you have to buy the ticket. You don't need to buy the bus. Yes. Then comes security, safety, timing, all those things. Imagine if this becomes safer and secure. Right? Have you ever traveled out of country? So, if you go to, you traveled. Where did you go, Monica?
Thailand and Bali.
Bali, okay. So if you ever go to London, my favorite place, right? Any person, however rich they are, in central London at least, they don't have a parking place also. So they all will use underground metro, whatever you call it, tubes they call them. Right? Yes. It's safe, perfect timing. You know, somebody who is earning $1 million every week also will go in that. All hedge fund managers and all, because exact timing. Perfect, on dot, it will come, it will move. So safe, clean, first class compartments are amazing. So that means public transport, if it becomes that safe, that clean, then we will go same way. Now what is the worry? If ICICI Bank goes through this, then there is a probability somebody sitting in the bus next to you, you don't know who he is, who or she, right? Or this person may enter into your network. So there are two problems when you go, when you leave your laptop or something, and you know, you turn this side, the laptop might disappear, but in your own car, it will be there, right? So there are issues. So if you fix those issues in the public transport, then that can be taken. Right? But it's expensive, but it should be taken care of. If it is taken care, then everybody will go in public transport the way the people go in London. Are you understanding? So why am I talking about all these things? See, this how clumsy this diagram is. You want a beautiful diagram? I have one for you. Right? This is what I was... Right? But remember this. When you make a paper dirty like this, that means you are learning. All of your pen and paper, your notes, your white papers, the more you soil them, the more you learn. The more you draw those diagrams, the more you feel it, you learn more. Okay. But otherwise, you want a beautiful diagram. That's it. You have a network. This is what you are going to learn now. But we are still there. What is CCNA? right? CCNA teaches you how a LAN functions. See this, in a LAN these days, you have hybrid networks. You have a wired network, you have a wireless network. You can't ignore that part because not every office now is connected like this. So here you have switches, right? You have switches, these cable systems. Here you'll have probably wireless access points, they call them, wireless LAN controllers, they call them. We'll come across all those things. That's fine. That's my job to teach you. So how to set up this? How to set up this? A branch office one and a branch office two. Then comes the router. Then how to configure it? How to manage it? Cisco is the world number one in producing these routers and switches. So Cisco certifies you. Hey, you recruit this person. That's why certification. If they want a project, then the client customer is giving you a project. Then he says, boss, how many CCNA certifieds, how many CCNP certifieds are there with you? Your company go and sells that. Hey, give us that project. We'll do it. We have these qualified people with us. So Cisco is certifying. Yes, these people can troubleshoot things here about the switches. And it's only three systems. Imagine if there are 3,000 systems or 30,000 systems. It gets very clumsy there. So it says, yes, we have people certified. Cisco certifies, yes, if you recruit these people, they can handle the setup. And then how they know how to configure this router, they know how to connect to this branch office through a dedicated line or through internet. See, this branch is connected through internet. Then the moment you connect to internet, they know how to secure this network. And this traffic which is going here, they know how this is securely sent. Do you understand? If somebody is working from home, see, these people, either you are browsing the internet or working from home, they know how to set up these kind of things. So the need of the hour, right? So Cisco certifies, you can do these things. You can connect your organization to internet. You can connect your organization to the outside world. You can manage these routers. This internet is full. Imagine this is Airtel. They may be having thousands of routers here. If this is, AT&T, he may be having thousands and lakhs of routers there, right? So he may be ACT. So if you get a job here, then they know how to, you can make people connect these things. So this is what it is. This is what any network or any diagram. That's what Cisco says. Yes, if you recruit them, they can do these things. They're associate level. So that's where, probably some of the things maybe I would have said a little extra because, there is a professional level post-graduation. You are doing a graduation now, post-graduation, right? You will do some specialization. You know exactly more into the routing. So what you are doing is CCNA enterprise, right? Core or something, what they are calling it. Right? That's why they teach you a little bit about wireless also. Then in wireless in this network, now slowly that software defined thing is coming, software defined networking, the software defined LAN, software defined WANs, right? So there is an introduction here, a little bit about automation. Then professional level, you learn more. Same thing, same diagram. Professional level, you learn more. Any network diagram is this. Professional level, you learn more things, deeper things. Expert level, you are an expert, you know everything about it. Do you understand? Right? That's what CCNA is. By the end of the course, if you learn properly, you should not be surprised about any of these things. You know exactly how they work. Yeah, you practice, you'll be able to do it. You don't practice, that's your choice. But I'll teach you whatever I said. These are the things. Some of them, even if they're not in the syllabus, I'll teach you because that makes little sense. Some of them I may not go very deep because Cisco says, okay, stop them at this level for an associate level. But broadly, yes, this is what you are going to learn in this course. Any doubts?
Yes, I had one.
Yeah, Monica.
When you were saying that junctions we are going through, so when we can talk about in the terms of network, you said that through router. So is it like router is behaving like a gateway? Like a what is the difference between that junction and gateway?
Junction is the name coined by Mohan. Okay. router is at your outside, right? So if mm-hmm. if you take your, this is your home, mm-hmm. right? You go out yeah. of your home through your gate, isn't it?
Yeah.
So router's old name was gateway.
Okay, so the router is the device which
router is also called gateway.
Okay.
Because when it is doing this job, mm-hmm. when it is at the gate, say imagine this is a network, right? There is this router is at the gate, correct? It's at yeah. the gate, right? It's going out. So this is your home. You're going out of this gate,
mm-hmm.
right? But imagine there is a router here. There's 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 a router here. They're all doing the same, just same component. But this is the one at the gate, but they are in the middle somewhere.
Yeah.
That's why I use the word junction. Router's old name was gateway. Even before that, 25 years before, they used to call this intermediate system. See, router mm-hmm. is not the component which directly they produced. Initially, what they used to do is they used to take a system, connect to network cards, because mm-hmm. junction has to connect to one side, right? Router will have multiple things. So then they used to enable routing here. So that's why they used to call intermediate system, because this side is one network, that side is another network. In between, router is the one which connects multiple networks, right?
Yes.
So they used to call it intermediate system. Intermediate system is an old name. After that, sometime they call it gateway. Then now they are calling it router because it's doing bigger job, right? It's not only gateway.
Yes.
Gate is just at the gate when you are at the gate.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So correct. Same diagram, if we go back here. So this router, you can call it a gateway, but you can't call it a gateway, right? That's why I said junction.
Mm-hmm.
But they're all routers. Routers, another name is gateway.
Oh.
When it is at the gate.
Sure. Thank you.
Yeah. Any other doubts? Gateway is basically the exit point that exits you to the outside world. From your home, you get out, right? From your street, you get out. From your gated community, you get out.
Okay.
Right, that's how it works. Okay, now imagine router is in a way, another junction I said. Now, another terms, I sometimes prefer to say, this is like a courier guy, Blue Dot courier. Now, whatever this network gives, this guy packs it and delivers to this guy. Right? This is Blue Dot Bangalore office. This is Blue Dot Mumbai office. He'll take it, then unpack it and give it to this guy. Right? Blue Dot Bangalore office, then gives it to Airtel office. Then it goes somewhere. It'll reach Amazon. It's like a courier guy. Pack it, deliver it. Imagine there is an young guy. Okay. He finished his graduation and came to Bangalore in search of his life, let's assume. So he came today to the Bangalore. Let's say yesterday, Sunday, he came to the Bangalore, now thinking that, you know, okay, slowly let's go. You know, COVID is, anyway, it has to be there with us. So last 6 months he's at home. So he came to Bangalore in search of his life. So a couple of, you know, his friends are there. He went to their friends and then he went to, you know, he saw the Sunday classifieds and then he found a job in courier company, let's assume. Then today, Monday, he attended an interview. They asked him a couple of questions. Hey, you know, Kannada, you know, English, you have a bike or something like that. Then, okay, he got a job, assume. So less than 24 hours in Bangalore, he got a job. And Tuesday morning, he said, Tuesday is not a good day. Wednesday onwards, I'll come for the work. Wednesday, he went to the work. Right? When Wednesday went to the work, his boss has given him 1,000 letters. He said, go distribute. Good. I got a job. Now I have to distribute. Now he looks at the address. First main, second cross, third block. What is this main cross block here? In my village, I know only Gandhinagar. Anywhere in this country, you'll have Gandhinagar, right? Nothing against Gandhi, okay? I'm just telling you. And again, anyway, batch started. I want to give you a disclaimer. See, by this time you would have understood, you know, my style of teaching is I keep giving examples, I keep talking about general things so that the subject will see. Subject you will learn when there is a story around it. right? For example, I'll ask you a question. When is the first railway line in India? What is the first railway line in India? Anybody knows? First railway line in India.
Yeah, it's a Thane, Mumbai to Thane, Central.
Yeah, Mumbai to Thane, right? See, Lakshmipathy answered this. When did Lakshmipathy would have learned it in 8th class? Probably 30 years back. But he remembered it. If I ask him the same question, same test class, 8th book to 8th class test book, right? Young guys, you have to know you guys are not remembering things. You have not answered it. So mobiles are doing damage to your brain. So if you see here, same test book, he studied Mumbai to Thane, same place here, you know, first telephone exchange. But he will not remember that. Even if I ask, he won't remember first telephone exchange. Same textbook, right? In history, somewhere in social studies, he would have studied. But Mumbai to Thane, he remembers it. Why? Because as a kid, an 8th class or 9th class kid, he would have imagined a train track and a railway station and train moving here. Because the Mumbai to Thane, it resembles a journey. He would have imagined a railway station. He would have imagined a railway station of Mumbai VT and then Thane railway station. And then he would have thought that, okay, the train is moving. He remembered it after so many years also. That's the beauty of memory. When there is a story around it, you'll remember. Right? Which year? Probably he may not remember. Right? You know, first connectivity from London to Delhi, you know, it is in 1860. 1860, there were telephone lines across the globe. That is why telephone guys will do the, even now this job is done by telephone guys. Why do you think BSNL is doing this job? For hundreds of years, they are there. Right? Why? So why I talk these things is, so that if you have any small thing, you'll remember. So why I'm giving this disclaimer is, sometimes if I say Gandhi now, Gandhinagar everywhere, then you should not feel that I'm anti-Gandhi or something. Okay, because you're all Google generation. Suddenly you write a review that might spoil my life. You know, there is a review about me saying that I'm a Tamilian. Because in a classroom, I would have given a Tamil exam. I'm not a Tamilian. I don't understand Tamil. But somebody, he wrote that I'm a Tamil biased person. Because I gave that example in the classroom. Because something I would have studied in the newspaper in the morning. I don't even know what I did. Probably I would have spoken about a Rajinikant. I say that because you remember things, right? So anything I say, I'm a political. Whatever my affiliations or my things, I will not bring into the class. But generally, I'm a political. I'm not. So I don't have time for all these things at first place. So I'll give examples, whether I talk about Modi or G or, you know, Gandhi or, you know, Rahul Gandhi or anything I say, I do it because you will collect it, a Trump or something. So I'm telling you, first class itself, I want to tell you, don't think that, you know, I'm, because one student wrote, I'm actually politically influencing them. There is an election between routers. So I spoke about election one day. And then one day I spoke about Shah Rukh Khan or Salman Khan or something. He said, I'm, you know, religion, racist type. So yeah, so I'm not, okay. I give examples. This is a classic example, Mumbai to Thane. So I try to build a story around it so that you will remember it. Okay, see, 10 years back, 20 years back, when Lakshmipathy were doing it, I wouldn't have said all these things. But over a period of time, I understood, right? You because I'm an old style teacher. You know, it was different style because 25 years, right? It's good time. But now I have to change to according to you. So you have this one magical instrument in your hand. Whatever you write, it will define me actually. Very interestingly. Okay. So first day, disclaimer, I'll give only to give you an example so that you will remember it. Nothing to do with anything. I'm actually apolitical. I don't bother about most of the things. Right. When I sit with my classmates and when I talk something or my age group, my friends, it's just general chat. That's it. And then there's nothing like, right. So that's what I'm telling you. So Gandhinagar, just because, you know, I interesting observation. There is no town in this country which doesn't have a Gandhi Road and Gandhinagar. So I said that. Okay. Anyway, I deviated. So yeah, in between, the deviation is also interestingly required. Again, I'm telling you, it's there is some that's called constructive distraction, because you can't concentrate for hours together. In between, I have to talk some nonsense to release your thing and then bring you back into the subject. That's how the teaching works, basically. Anyway, so if you see here, what I'm trying to tell you is, where we deviated, anybody remembers? That courier guy. Okay, so the courier guy, how he delivers? How he delivers, right? Without knowing an address. First day, 1,000 letters. Where is first main? Where is second main? Where is third block? Where is fourth block? I don't know anything. That's why when a courier guy joins a job, his boss will tell him, hey, you go with the senior for a week. Now that senior will teach him. Right, this guy will, now this younger guy will ride the bicycle, senior will sit, relax, younger guy will carry things, but he'll be teaching. What he will be teaching him? The address. The classic thing that is required for a courier guy is an address. When he starts here, when he comes here, if he wants to reach, let's say this person, how many paths he will have? He might come like this, he might come like this, he might come like this, he might. So that senior will tell him, hey, this is the best path. You should go like this. So if you want to cover all of them, first you should go to him, then go to him, then go to him, then go to him. Then you can cover the entire area. So what basically he's learning is address. Without knowing an address, a courier guy cannot deliver. Without knowing an address, a CCNA cannot, you cannot become a CCNA. Because we are talking about connectivity, communication, networking. So what address a system will have?
IP address.
Yeah. See this for freshers especially, right? In a LAN, you will have systems, servers that may be of any size, just for fun. Hub will be looking like this. Hub will have less number of ports. Hubs are dead components. Nobody is using now, but you can use it. I have hubs, but nobody uses. I'll teach you the difference between a hub and a switch and a router, everything. Today, I told you, right? No technology today, just general talk. What are we going to learn? But hub looks like this. Hub is generally 8 ports will be there. Now, if you see switches, yes, this is how they look like. See, you can have 24 ports, 48 ports. They're expensive. Hub is about less than 1,000 rupees. Switch, sky is the limit. RJ45, yes, this pin is RJ45. Telephone pin is RJ11. If you see a telephone pin, that's RJ11. So you have these fiber optics cables, you can do this way. You can have RJ45, this is how your ports are connected to switch. This is how your server looms looks like, if you're a fresher. Those who know, that's fine. The LAN, yeah, with a hub you can connect like this, or with a switch with all those cables. That's how these cables will go and fix here. So most of you may be knowing it because freshers are, that's the beauty of my class, okay? There will be all kinds of people, all kinds of, so I will say experienced people may be thinking, what is this? But at the end of the day, I have to look at somebody like, you know, who is, see, somebody is in final year engineering, somebody is very fresh, just finished. So I have to keep them in mind, okay? So I don't ignore anyone. So I have to do this training. That's how it is. This is what wireless access point. So you can connect through wireless also. That's what your LAN works. We'll see how it works exactly. And then router comes. Yeah, router looks like this. Though we serve, so why you represent in circle also? See that router, this is how the blue color circle router is. See this arrow marks? You can go in multiple directions. Router can send and receive to multiple networks, junction. Remember this always, junction. What is like a junction? So LAN, and then you connect it. Then you connect to the outside world. See that? So you have a head office, you have a branch office, you can have a private WAN connectivity. Do you want a public WAN connectivity? This is private. This is public. LAN, WAN. Right? you can have a firewall security. You don't want unknown people to get in secure firewall. That's all it is, right? If you can, you can remove this also. This can do the same job, not a problem. You can keep this here also and this here also. It depends on your design, how you want it.
Even for the public network, there will be like junctions, huh?
Come again?
Even for a public network, there will be a junction, huh?
Ritesh, your voice from the beginning, actually, it's not clear.
Sir, even for the public network, there will be a router availability, huh?
Public network. Everywhere junction is required. When you want to go from one network to another network, you need routers everywhere. In fact, internet is full of routers.
Okay.
In fact, more routing is here only, right? This is a big network, right? Network of networks, right? The whole world is connected.
Okay.
There will be lakhs of routes here. Lakhs of networks. Okay. Not sir, thousands, lakhs.
Sir, there is a firewall, you said. In window operating system also, firewall is there, yes. Where inbound and outbound rules apply.
That is system level, right?
Yeah.
So yes. Host level firewalls are different, network level firewalls.
Oh. It is device, sir?
Yeah, you'll have a separate device, Cisco Advanced Security Appliance, Cisco Firepower. I mean, this is not part of your syllabus also. Okay. But yeah, you have to understand the network diagram, right?
Yes.
So that's how it is. So if you want security, you need a firewall. So I'll teach you a little bit, not little bit, actually, a lot of network security I'll teach. Okay. So okay. Yes, again, say this, we started here. What is CCNA? And we ended there. After all these things, again, this is the diagram. That's what you're going to learn. Any doubts?
Yes, I just wanted to know, when we are talking about private network and public network, mm-hmm. private is like, are we talking about VPNs or we are talking about LANs? So private, just want to understand that.
LAN is not, I'm talking about, LAN is different. LAN is anyway private all the time, right?
Mm-hmm.
When you want to go from your head office to branch office or outside,
mm-hmm.
you can have your own dedicated private networks. You have to pay more money for that. I told you, right? It's like your own car or your own street. So service providers, same service provider, same Airtel, same Jio, same Tata, same BSNL, will give you internet services. This is internet. That is only, they'll provide you the service from here to here. But you want from your head office to branch office, they will provide this service separately. They'll charge you more for that. Because you have to pay
so
for
that. Okay, so is it
like... this is a private network. See, here, this may be you. Okay, this may be me today. I'm sitting here and I'm teaching you. You are connected to the same internet. We both are using some Zoom application and we are talking to each other. This is public, right? Anybody can. So now if a new student joins, he can also come in. This is public. But this is, as I told you, let's say ICICI Bank Kormangala branch. This is ICICI Bank Mumbai office. They can have their own things, their own private dedicated lines, WAN connectivities.
Okay, so we can say that for business requirements, sometimes we are saying a dedicated line or lease line.
Same thing, lease line. This is lease line.
Yeah, and for house purpose, mostly...
Okay. Not again. See, this can be a lease line. Between these two points, I can give lease line means this dedicatedly, this much bandwidth is given to you.
Mm-hmm.
At your home, this is your home. Let's say this is you. This is your home. He has given you a broadband connection. Yeah. This is a different technology. Broadband and leased are technologies. Leased means what? You leased that car. That is for you. The car is given to you. That is for you. But it's, you leased it. You leased a house. You still stay there. Leased word is English. That's it. It is given. So here, leased line. This is also leased. This entire cable is leased to me. But for internet, leased line means from this point, a specific bandwidth is given to me. That is not a difference between public and private. For a public network also, I can have a leased line.
Okay.
I'll teach you how to configure. Leased is English, pure English. That connectivity is leased. In broadband, what happens? It's you dial-up kind of connection, right? You broadband, whenever you switch on, you use that and you use it. It's a different technology. Leaser and broadband are different technologies. That's it. So you cannot differentiate that, you know, leaser line means this and broadband. No, I can have an internet leaser line also.
Okay.
Okay. And VPN is totally different. I'll teach you when we reach there. It's too early for you today. We can't talk about too many things.
No, actually, yes, that's why I just wanted to understand because
VPN this is clear, right?
Yeah, clear.
And this is how it is. So when you go through internet, if you want to make it secure, I told you, right? Actually, I initially mentioned it. If your communication, you are going through your branch office through internet like this. Now that communication, you want to make it secure, you use those VPNs, virtual private networks. How, what, we'll teach, we'll go there. First day only too much, it will become.
Sure.
Sometimes egg first or chicken first type, right? Should I talk or should I not is also important. So anything I talk should not confuse people. So in the beginning, I don't want to talk about all those things. But as, in fact, I'll configure and just for your happiness, even though it is not part of your syllabus and all, I'll configure a leaser line to internet and I'll teach you. I'll configure a VPN and I'll teach you. Even though sometimes it says only just a description, your syllabus says some things only you need to describe, but I'll configure and I'll show it to you. So I'll teach you all these things. I'll in fact demonstrate all those things.
Okay, thank you.
Okay, you can create your own mini internets and you can practice all these things. You can create, see, internet is a public network. You can create your own mini internet in a lab environment and you can practice everything what you learn. That can be done.
Yeah.
Okay. So yeah. You can do it with a lot of my lab or simulators. Everything can be done. That, don't worry about that. So we're just starting our journey. Yeah. So now the address, you said IP address. When it comes to, you know, address, a systems will have a logical address and a physical address. Every system will have two addresses, physical address and a logical address. The physical address is what you call sometimes MAC address. Or hardware address. It has a beautiful name, burnt in address. What is that? See, in your system, wherever that cable goes, right? So if this system, if you want to connect your LAN, right? So this cable will go to the system somewhere, right? That part, I think I don't have that network card diagram somewhere here. I should put it there. So where you connect that cable here, that network card. So one end of your cable, especially I'm looking for the freshers. So one end goes to your system. One end goes to your switch or something, right? Like this. The end, the other end where it goes, that is network interface card. That is your network interface card. So that network interface card comes with that MAC address. If it's a system where you connect your cable, that is a 48-bit number expressed in hexadecimal. If you know hexadecimal numbers, you all know?
Yes, sir.
Right? 0, F, 1, 2, 2 3, F. Right? 9, after that A, B to F. Each one is 4 bits. Each one is 4 bits. You should know it, right? I'll give you, those who don't know, tomorrow I'll give that. 48 by 4, that means 12 hexadecimal digits. So the MAC address looks like this, some 0, 0. 50AB12CD34 like this. Okay. In this four, half of it is the manufacturer code or the vendor code, they call it. So whoever is the manufacturer, right? So that manufacturer, let's say Pegatron manufactured it or Dell manufactured it, you can actually say this. He will have his own number. Cisco manufactured. Cisco will. So they'll get that number. The rest of that is 2 to the power 24 numbers will be there. It's 48 bits. This is the card number actually. But this, is it looking like an address? Is it looking like an address when you look at it? You have to go. So somebody said, okay, you, imagine you asked me, where do I come to my... where do I come to the institute? If you want to come to the institute after this COVID thing and all, you want to do a lab and you want to come, say, where can I come and do the lab? If I ask you, hey, come to 215, Where is 215? What is the address? Is it looking like an address? No, it's not. It's not an address. Right? If I tell an address, right? Okay, you have to come to Kormangla. Kormangla so-and-so block, so-and-so, you know, building, so-and-so number. Then this is my address, Kormangla, right? 7th block, Raheja Arcade, Kormangla, Bangalore, 215, whatever the address. Address should have this whole process, right? So address cannot be a simple number, but this number cannot be an address, but we call it an address. This is actually a hardware identification. It's just a hardware ID. We call it hardware address, but it's just an identity, burnt in address. Why? It is burnt onto the chip of the network card. If you remove that card and put another card, the new address will come. So what is the purpose of this, you know? It's a hardware identification. When data enters into the system, remember this, I told you already, systems will behave like good human beings. When something entering into the system, system won't accept it. System will not accept anything. Whether it's a system, routers, anything, it will not accept unless and until it is supposed to take it. So when it comes to system, when a data system is an end component, system is an end node. Right? If this is a system, this is Monica's house or Monica's home, Monica is living here. If a courier guy comes and says that, hey, this package is for Ajit, Monica should not take it. Right? It is for Ajit, not for me. Right? If Ajit is living here, this is Monica, this morning for Monica comes, Ajit should not take it. But Ajit says, okay, let me see what is there for Monica, a little curious. But human beings can do that, but systems don't. Systems don't accept anything that doesn't belong to them. Then how do you know that they belong to them? They know it because they can check the MAC address. So any data which is entering into your system should and must have the MAC address. So that is what physical, why it's called MAC, I'll tell you later. That's what, why it's called physical address. It comes with the card. That's why it's burnt an address. So this is not an address. This is just an identification. Right? Now, if you see here, the logical address, that is what you're all saying IP address. Why IP address? Why not something else? See, actually, right? If you see an operating system, now you all know Microsoft operating systems, Windows, what we are using, Windows 10, right? We have Windows 8, Windows 7, Windows Server, so many things, Microsoft, Windows. Apple, Macintosh, right? Anybody knows novel NetWare? Old timers? There used to be an operating system called novel NetWare. And Unix platforms, IBM, OS2, AIX. See, 1960s and 70s, world number one was IBM. Come 80s, this was the world number one, actually, in operating system perspective. Microsoft entered mid-90s. Right? When Microsoft entered the market, you know, the situation was, right, if two systems wants to communicate with each other, right, they need something called a transport protocol. Transport protocol. Do you know any transport protocol? Have you heard of any?
FTP, file transfer.
FTP is an application. File transfer protocol is an application.
Okay.
Right? It's not a protocol. It's not a transport protocol. It's an application, just an application to exchange files, big files.
TCP and UDP.
TCP, UDP. So you all know TCP, UDP. I know that. You all know IP address. You all talk about TCP, UDP. Right? But interestingly, when IBM was the world number one, IBM has its own protocol called SNA. Smart or simple network architecture or smart network architecture, they call it. Novel has IPX, SPX. Anybody heard? You study electronics and telecommunication, Tenenbaum, all those commerce and all those books, it'll be there. Of course, we don't study. That's a different thing. Apple has something called Apple Talk. till 2005 in Bangalore, there is an AppleTalk support center actually. Microsoft has something known as NetBIOS. So what I was telling is, say in 1995, you are using a Windows 95 or Windows 98 operating system. When you install, there's every probability that it will install NetBIOS first. Then you will go and insert a CD and install. Some of you wouldn't have been born at that time. You install TCP/IP separately. There was no interoperability. You know, if I have a novel server, then if I have a novel server and then I have novel client, then they'll talk. If I have Windows client, they don't talk. No national permit vehicle, only state permit vehicle. Tamil Nadu in Tamil Nadu, Karnataka in Karnataka. Cover issues were there. They don't talk to each other. Then Windows said, okay, I'll develop a new protocol, NW-Link, Novel Windows Linking Transport Protocol. So customization. Windows server has to talk, Windows client, because Windows is a user-friendly client. Novel is a powerful server. If they want to talk to these two, then I need a customized one. So that is when Novel actually was killed by this guy, actually. There is a court case also. But anyway, that's not what we are talking about. So interoperability, now customization, different. So everyone has a different transport protocol. Till 1999, every day, transport protocol was active. In CCNA syllabus, I used to teach IPX, SPX. You all know only TCP and UDP. Why? Because post 1999-2000, they all are dead actually. You just need to know that they exist. They're all dead. Why? See, what happened was parallelly 1960s onwards, the whole world was looking for this common protocol. See, Department of Defense, US, you all must have studied this. Department of Defense, US with University of California, they were working on that ARPA project. Every computer science textbook will have advanced research projects associates. See, US is a huge country, east coast to west coast, thousands of kilometers. You know, from here to here, if you travel in a flight and from here to London, it's the same time you can actually reach. That's a kind of a big country that is. Now, if you see here, now, if somebody, you know, wants to communicate for military purposes, Department of Defense, they wanted technology to be developed. Then over the globe, actually, Europe also, some technology was development is going on and all that. So, but they successfully connected. Once they connected, Department of Defense said, okay, University of California, you developed it. You can use for education purposes. UC and Stanford, I think University of Utah, I think one more university, the famous four, they call it. They all, this is how internet started for education purposes, universities. Once they started, what happened? Slowly they started opening up. It's like to the people, by the people, for the people. They said, anybody can contribute. So that protocol is your TCP/IP, which is opened up. So Internet Engineering Task Force, Institute of Electrical and Electronic Engineering. These are the people who, so now today, if you sit here and you are a programmer, you wrote a program and send it to these guys, and you say that, okay, I developed something for TCP/IP, they will publish it. They'll say request for comment. And then if everybody likes it, they can use it. That's what opening up. You can say Cisco developed something. Cisco can keep it to themselves. No, Cisco says, no, we wanted to give it to be public. Then they can give it. So like that, they develop TCP/IP. It's not a single protocol. TCP and UDP at one level, internet protocol, address resolution protocol, reverse address resolution protocol, internet control messaging protocol, internet group management protocol. They all are part of the stack actually. See, now you sit on one system, very interesting thing. You sit on one system and you type www.google.com, you reach Google and come back. To go there and come back, you need TCP, you need UDP, you need IP, you need ARP. From here to here, if all these protocols individually do their jobs so that you can reach Google and come back. We call this TCP/IP because this is a popular combination. That's it. Main job is done by TCP or IP. How exactly it works, I'll teach you later. Don't worry about that. I'm not teaching anything. Transmission control protocol. I'm just telling you the name. I'm not teaching it. User datagram protocol, internet protocol, address resolution protocol, reverse address resolution protocol. I'm just giving you the names. reverse address resolution protocol, internet control messaging protocol, internet group management protocol. I will teach you as and when we reach there. I'm not going to teach you, okay, this TCP, give a definition, and this UDP, give a definition. No, I'm not teaching like that. As and when we reach there, what is the job of the protocol, how it is doing, we will see it live. Okay, so in this, IP is the addressing scheme. This, that logical address, IP address. That's why you all know IP address. So if you see last, I don't know how much time I'm teaching you now. What's the time? Good. Yes, 1 hour, 20 minutes. What I was teaching you is why you should start your class with IP address. So if you go back here, yeah, you can do it here. CCNA is a course which teaches you how to communicate between systems, networks, end-to-end communication. If you say, if somebody asks you what is CCNA, CCNA teaches you how to systems communicate wherever they are, whatever they are, and the technologies involved. So I have a system in Bangalore and I have a system in Tokyo. I don't want to communicate between them. After this course, you should be able to do it given the resources. So to communicate, I need the address. Every operating system they used to have, now they all have only one transport protocol, TCP/IP, one address, IP address. So we will start tomorrow. We'll be the first class technically with IP address. That will be the first topic I'm going to teach. Till now, why IP address? Why? Because to communicate, you need an address. You have a lot of transport protocols. Currently, the main transport protocol we use in IP, TCP/IP protocol, and that address is IP. So we will start our journey into networking with IP address. Any doubts? Is that clear? That is the first, right? Next day, next 2 days, that is Wednesday and Thursday, I will teach you two classes, OSI reference model. OSI reference model, some of you would have studied in college. Now it's TCP model actually. Now you don't have OSI, it's becoming old, but they both are same. I'm going to teach you two classes, OSI reference model. So this week, this is what I'm going to teach. The next week, I'll teach you, first 2 days, I'll teach something interesting called subnetting, IP address manipulations. My two classes I'll teach. Then starts our journey into networking. Okay, I will slowly build your logic. One day I'll teach you how the LAN functions. We will, from this class onwards, I'll start demonstrating. So these six classes, it'll be theory, fundamentals. Then I'll start demonstrating. One day I'll teach how the LAN works. Then I'll teach you how the router is configured. Then we'll connect a router. Then we will go to another router. Then we will go between two networks. Then manually through a static routing. And then you have some dynamic routing, how the routers learn the routes, whether you configure it, automatically they learn it. Then I'll teach you how to connect to internet. Then how the internet connectivity is, then how these two can talk via internet, how to secure this, how the firewall works. One by one, I'll be building this. I'll be building this diagram for you. So if you want to seriously learn everything I teach structurally, you put it in your notes. There will be by the end of the course, you will have a nice project of an enterprise network in your thing. Switching, actually, I don't teach in the beginning. Generally, every textbook will have switching in the beginning. But towards the, after this entire thing over, I'll integrate you. Switching, I'll teach about a week. About four classes, sometimes more, depending on how fast you pick up. See, I'm not in a hurry to finish. The whole concept is learning. See, after these many years, you know, what matters to me? So everybody will go through a phase in the life. So now after these many years, what matters to me is how good you learn matters to me rather than how fast I finish. I reach that age and, you know, some kind of an actualization. And I feel happy if you learn and you get a job. My money will come anyway. It doesn't matter, right? I reached a stair where now everybody, like everybody, I'm also struggling. My class generally today, if you see 8-9 people, there was a time when you know, when I start in a regular classes, my classes will 40, 50 people will be there, 100 people will be there. So it's just different, right? So, but what matters is how much you learn. So 8 to 10 in the evening for two months, you are sitting here and you're trying to learn. How much you learn matters. So what speed we learn, how we learn is based on your responses, how things are happening. Okay, you have to keep that in mind. Okay, so I'm not in a hurry. So I'll teach this. Then I'll teach wireless LAN. How the wireless LAN, a couple of classes we'll spend on wireless LAN. And then we'll spend a couple of classes on automation, right? How the programming is entering into our area, right? What is required? So all those things we will learn. You understand? So Cisco has given you some, you know, syllabus, whatever syllabus. There are six headers. One is like, you know, architecture, infrastructure or something, IP services, something like that, automation. So Cisco will give you, but I don't, you know, Cisco will give based on the kind of work it is. Okay. So you need to understand how the infrastructure looks like, then how these things look like. But while learning, it's not like that. We have to build it, right? So I'll teach everything what Cisco says, but I will build in my own style. Indian students have their own style of learning. So one by one, first I'll teach you how to build this. Then next I'll go there. Next I'll go there. So slowly I will add flavor to it, right? Yeah. In fact, Ram was saying IPv6, he is looking. Yes, what you are going to learn tomorrow will be version 4. So one class I'll teach IP version 6, which is a new one. Now everybody needs it. Now the old one is dying. So I'll teach IP version 6 one day, right? So everything required for you, which will be useful to you, I'll teach. Every class is important. It's not like an engineering college. Some of you are freshers. Okay, I have a choice. I'll only learn this. No, this is, you don't know which one is going to help you in an entry. And everything is required for an enterprise network, right? So it's a good course. It's up to you how much you want to learn. I will do my job. That's how it works. So yeah, that's it for today from my side. Any doubts, any clarifications? You know what is CCNA? Tomorrow somebody asks you, hey, where are you going 8 to 10 in the night, disappearing? Can you tell them?
Yeah.
Yeah? Any doubts, Monica?
No.
Right. That's good. All. Yeah. So tomorrow we will start our journey with IP address. Okay. And yeah, as I started today, about 8:05. Yeah. 5 minutes. I can wait 5 minutes because a couple of people joined a little late today. So first day, right? So anywhere between, see, depending on anywhere between 8 o'clock is your class. I don't waste your time, right? Between 8:05 to 8:10. In between, suddenly I'll start the class. So if you should be here by at least by 8:05. Introduction of any topic is very important. I can understand your things and all, but at the end of the day, you paid for it. We have to go with everyone. I can't make other people wait. And again, don't plan for 8:05 and come at 8:10. So yeah. So if everybody comes at 8 o'clock, I might start also. That's how it works. So let's keep it average between 8:05, 8:06. Anytime I'll start around that time in the class. Okay. And then okay. By 10, depends. Normally classes won't cross. I'll leave a little early only because I design lectures like that. And then the speed at which I teach, you have to tell me, right? If you are not, if you are okay with that, I'm fine. You say that, okay, slow down, I'm fine. You know, I generally go slow. Sometimes I get excited, human being, right? Yeah, you get that emotion and then you, yeah. Otherwise, I prefer to teach slow, slowly talk about it. And then I'll give you gaps. Tomorrow, today is introduction. Tomorrow, if you say, for example, my style of teaching, I'll, because first day I have to tell you that. So anything I teach, okay, this point, okay, this is finished. Then I'll say, okay, couple of minutes, 2 minutes, you go through it, write down,
sir.
Then ask me. Then I'll give a gap. Then I'll give another, like that I'll teach. Okay. So I'll always give you when an important topic finishes, 2 minutes time in between where you can write a notes, ask me doubts and all. Once this concept is clear, then I'll move to another concept. So every topic I'll do like that. Okay, if any doubt, you can ask. If you are not able to ask in the middle, I'll give you that couple of minutes time for you to consolidate and ask me a doubt. That's how I teach. Yeah? Any doubts? Somebody saying something? Yeah, I can't hear.
Yeah, Mohan, any course material we'll receive?
Yeah, so that soft copy will be sent to you. Great. Because now the books are there, but lying down, nobody is sitting. So there is a lab manual and then some textbooks. So they will share with you everything around this time after submitting. First 1 week, I don't want anybody to do any experimentation.
Great.
Let the fundamentals sink in. After this class is over, once I introduce you to the lab, that day they will share you in the WhatsApp group whatever material required.
Great. Okay. Thank you.
That's how it works. Oh. Yes. Yeah, Monica.
No, I was saying, okay, that's okay.
Yeah. Good night then.
Okay, good night.
Yeah, see you tomorrow.
Thank you for the session.
Thank you.
Good night, sir.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. Good night.